want to come and speak after, if you can just line to the side. Thanks a million.
Thanks, Louise. Listen, I'll be quick, but first of all, I just want to pay tribute to Spark, because to be honest with you, without Spark, this issue would not have been the thorn in the side of this government and of Joan Burton over the last 2 years in the way that it has. They have had to face forensic questioning, detailed arguments, all the facts, every bit of propaganda that has been put out by the government to justify these absolutely vindictive, nasty and cruel cuts. Spark have been able to come back point by point and expose the lies and expose the propaganda, and they deserve a lot of credit for that. And they have provided us with the ammunition to use when we've argued with the government. But I have to say, really, Joan Burton should be utterly ashamed of herself, because everything that has come to pass, the dramatic increase in child poverty, increased by 137,000 extra children living in poverty, by the near doubling of the number of single mothers living in a situation of deprivation, has occurred since she introduced the budget cuts in 2012. And it was all predicted by Spark and those who represented low parents in the Dáil. We said this is going to happen, and she denied it down to the ground. She actually farcically claimed that these measures that she was introducing were going to activate people. They were going to help them get into work, when we know that the consequences was to do the exact opposite and drive them out of work and put lone parents and their kids, in many cases, in a completely untenable position. So apart from anything else, it is utter incompetence. And of course, the other thing that Joan Burton did, which flew in the face of any kind of logic, and which has been proven to be utter insanity, which has also hit lone parents, was the cuts in the rent allowance caps. She said, by cutting the rent allowance caps, we are going to, and I'm quoting her, reduce rents. As a result of that measure, more people are homeless in this city and in this state than have been for decades, and of course rents have gone through the roof. Now for nothing else, incompetence, Joan Burton should go. It's absolutely unbelievable. But I think it is very important that we also join the dots. You see, we've heard for the last several years that yes, austerity is tough, yes, it's cruel, it's unfair, but it was necessary because we have all felt the pain. We've all felt the pain, apparently. Well, we've just come from a debate where we discover, I think most of you know this, but it's important to underline it, where we discover some people didn't feel the pain at all, but in fact got tremendously richer while ordinary citizens were getting poorer. In 2009, Dennis O'Brien had €2.5 billion in personal wealth. That's a lot, isn't it? But do you know how much he's got now? €5.6 billion. So, while you got poor, while your children got poor, while the housing crisis got worse, while the public services you depend on were slaughtered, someone else got €3 billion richer. Now, to my mind, that's a straight transfer. That's from your pocket, from the services, from the livelihoods, from the quality of life of your kids and your families, straight into his pocket. That is what's been going on. And we have to say, that is not good enough. The wealth is in this country, it just has to be fairly distributed. I mean, does Dennis O'Brien work a lot harder than us? No. He just happens to know the right people. While lone parents are struggling to look after their kids, working all sorts of hours, and are left impoverished at the end of the week, and in many cases facing homelessness. That is how sick and unjust and unfair the system is. Some people, just because of who they know, become billionaires with multiple properties all over the world. They don't even pay tax in this country. But the ordinary people who are struggling, who are contributing to our society, who want to, and who are bringing up their kids and are fighting to do so, are struggling on the poverty line. It's not acceptable, and fair play to you for keep fighting it.